mathematics is a little bit off from mine. I gotta empty my purse. I gotta bring some of my substance, resources to you regularly. And you telling, and I gotta give in the process, all that, and be a giver. And you telling me in the process that you're gonna increase me. My accountant and your accountant don't match. Not only do I don't match, but my neighbors don't make no sense of me. And they make some pretty good arguments. Put in a 401k, child, and so many years later, you retire worry-free. You've been giving it to that church for all them years. Wow. So,
they got to realize that not necessarily giving to the church, but giving unto God.
That's
where the wealth
is. So, the promise and the obedient steps along the way, how committed are you to the process? You got to love your brother, your neighbor. I don't care if he spit in your face. The meek shall inherit the earth.
So Abraham had another son, right?
Ismael.
Catch me out.
His other son, he loved him to the same, didn't he?
That's right. Yes. No question about it.
God told him to get together.
No question about it. But God told him, this son that came the son of promise. Son of promise. There's no big deal by Ismael. He came through a young girl. This is a son of promise to an old woman. And an old man.
Ishmael was blessed as well. He was not the child of promise.
He was not the child of promise.
But he was blessed.
So God says, I promise you a wife, I promise you substance, I promise you all this, all that. Let me help you out, God. No, I don't need no help. But we do human test comes up. Humanity tries to get in there, help out. God, as everybody says last week, I make the promise, and I'm telling you, it's going to be such an awesome promise that you'll know that it ain't you, because you can't bring this to pass. Only God. That's what we studied last week. So, all right. We've been doing that for a while. Abraham built an altar, bound up Isaac, laid him on the altar upon the wood. We got silence. Now, let's get into James, the second chapter, verse 20. Keep the place here, though. We're trying to demonstrate our faith. We're trying to show that I'm in faith. How do you show that you're in faith? You stay devoted, by the word committed, to the process. And it's more than lip service. You just can't talk about faith. Faith is more than just talking about it. So here goes, I said the second chapter, verse 20. Here's James's philosophy. Y'all don't like that word, philosophy. Okay. What does he say? Verse 20 through 22.
But wilt thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead? Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he had offered Isaac his son upon the altar? Seeing thou how faith wrought with his works, and by works was faith made perfect?
Faith was made complete by his action. Abraham could have believed that promise all he wanted to, without marching up there, without the wood, the knife, and the fire, and the kid, his faith was zero. So he had to bring the kid up, climb the mountain, take the three-day journey, go 50 miles, pass by all of those unbelieving realities out there, and then put the kid on the altar and tell him, God sees. It don't look good, it don't make sense, but God sees. why don't you just go, you know, like Job's wife, why don't you just...
Her son died. That's what she did.
Gave him some worldly advice. Why don't you just stop going to that church? Why don't you just hold back on some of that giving up? Why don't you just stop participating? Because it makes sense this way. And they say, well, Abraham worked it out. He took the action steps to get to the end results. And God will want to know from all of us, are you willing to take the action steps? Yeah. Then God says, okay, let me see him. Let me see him. Brother James, you love your wife? Yeah. Sister Deborah, does James love you? Has he showed you anything lately that he loves you? Let me pick on the runner. What has he done for you lately? What's some of these concrete, tangible stuff? See, now you got to go out and get another Christmas gift. let me see. That's what God is saying. You with me? Yeah, I'm with you. All right, here we go.
Let me see.
Here we go. Yeah, we in business together. I'm in business with Brother Curtis. And I said, Curtis, you put up all the capital? And we got it going. Curtis is going to say, wait a minute, Brother Williams. I'm with you. You put up all the work and money, Curtis, on this project. Put all the money up front. I'm with you.
Curtis is going to say, talk is cheap.
Talk is cheap. Put something here.
Curtis. Put your money where your mouth is.
Put me on this one. Yeah, I'm with you. Well, I'll put something there. Show that that's what God is saying. You still with me on this faith thing? Yeah. Well, let me see. You still with me? That's what God is doing to Abraham. You still with me? Yeah. You still believe in me? Yeah. Then take the action steps. So James is saying here that no, works don't make you righteous, but works will prove your faith. I'm just believing and obeying, and here it is. You see me out. I'm believing and obeying. Okay. Praise God. So, verse 10, Abraham stretched forth his hand, took the knife to do what?
Slay his son.
Kill the son. Angel of the Lord, I believe it was the Lord Jesus Christ, called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, here I am. Lay not thine hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him, for now I know. Wait a minute. What about before? God says, now I know. What about before? I didn't know. Didn't know. God says, I didn't know. Didn't know.
Well, you know, I think before everything that he had was stuff, but everything he owned was stuff that, you know, he just was blessed with.
Okay.
But Isaac was something he asked for.
Right.
Yeah. He told God that's what he wanted.
Right.
So now you're sacrificing what you want.
Right.
That's because I asked you. Now I know.
So I bring it back to 2012 or 2011. Some things God don't know. Not too sure. What else? Are you really there? Are you really with God? Are we really with God on this?
Yeah, he'll say, do you love me? And they'll tell you what to do if you do love me. He kept saying, Peter, do you love me? Yeah, well.
Feed my.
Let me see. And then God had nerve to tell Abraham, now I know. Now I know that you have faith. Mm-hmm. Now I know that you have faith because you obeyed what I told you to do on that test. And with some tests, we have to go ahead and admit that we what? Back off the first. Later.
Yeah. that some tests come up and we decide, the test to tempt us to take the easy way out, or the quick,
with you on that
the
one,
quick fit.
Name something else, maybe I can go along with it. Something that happened right there, I ain't with you on that. And God says, I can see, I can tell. Don't mean God doesn't love us, but what he'll do, he'll try and get you into the development of getting there. Get you into moving incrementally, you and I, incrementally with him to say, okay, I can go all the way with this. You know, for example, swimming. For, you know, some, anybody can swim? Most folks can swim? Yeah. Even today, when I step into the water, first thing I want to do is fill out how
I go.
I go. Not how deep, how cold.
How cold.
How cold is that water? Everybody. What does that got to do with anything? Nothing? After you're in there for about 30 seconds, you can't even feel a little temperature. But everybody, this, when God tells you about walking, coming along with him on this faith journey, all we want, we all want to
test it out.
I ain't there. Brother Williams personally would say, let's see, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 in this room. Don't take a flu shot. Don't worry about it. But some of us in here would say, I ain't with you on that. Get into the building, I say I advocate. Don't take a flu shot. Somebody, I ain't with you. Okay. Williams is there. Same thing with God on us. All right, we back off. Ain't there. What time is it, y'all? I gotta get out of here.
Yeah, and then 10, there are sometimes when you can actually say that I'm not there. And you can look back on your life when there, and you weren't there then, but you might be there now.
You might be there
God
now.
God brought you there.
Yeah, and see, the development steps is that take the stuff and come make the sacrifice. Brother Curtis said you got to take your, Sister Hill said you got to take your Bible. Curtis says a notepad. Somebody over here says you got to come to the house of the Lord with an offering if you want to get there. And God will help you get there, but he's wanting to see if you, along the journey, you're bringing the goods with you. Williams wants to be a millionaire, but he stopped tithing 6-7 months ago.
6-7 years
ago. You ain't getting there. I'm talking about James. Okay, verse 13. Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in the thicket of his horns. Abraham went, took the ram, offered him burnt offering, and instead of his son. So I think we're going to get to where verse 14. Abraham called the name of the place. What is God doing?
Providing.
God is providing. So that's what he does. He's providing us with the necessary things we need along the path walk to faith. God, he will provide. God sees, oh, I'm in the midst of this test. I'm in the trench. And somebody said, what's going on? You don't have an answer. You don't know. You can't say. You can't explain. All you can say is like my grandmother used to say, God sees. God sees. We're just going to keep on waiting. God sees. Okay, God sees. That's enough.
You know, the interesting thing is when Abraham started on his journey, there was a test all along the way. Mm-hmm. God didn't provide until the very end. Mm-hmm. And for us today, a parallel is Abraham endured the test. Mm-hmm. He met the test.
Yeah.
We have to, along the way, sometimes, you know, you fall out and you never get to the point where God will provide because we've fall by the wayside.
Step back.
Exactly. But he continued because he knew what God had promised him until he got there where God provided.
He considered the promise. So in all the tests that we're in, the only thing you can look at is, you know, your natural eye and all that could get you off track. The only thing you can count on is what? What did he say? Who was that, Candy? Yes, we'll get out there.
You asked why you kept saying Galatians at the beginning. Galatians 3:6. Says, even as Abraham believed God, and it was accounted to him for righteousness, Know ye therefore that they that are of faith, the same are the children of Abraham. And the scripture foreseeing that God would justify the heathen through faith, preached before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, in these shall all nations be blessed.
Amen.
So then they which be of faith are blessed with faithful Abraham.
Amen. When God told Abraham all nations on the earth be blessed through you, I don't think Abraham could understand that. But now you and I can be blessed because we take the same faith test that Abraham took along the journey. And, you know, sometimes we try to help out like Abraham did with Hagar. And a lot of times we pull back from that promise. Lord, I believe you, but I can't do that.
I don't even think it was possible for Abraham to know. I don't even think it was possible for Abraham to know what the magnitude of that was, because in that time, people didn't even know that the world was as big as it was.
Yeah.
They just thought the world was those little countries and nations that were around them.
Yeah.
Because it took him out of
all nations of the earth.
Sand and stars.